What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome to another Top 10, and the Black Ops 3 beta is right around the corner, but there's also another beta next month that is a pretty big deal, too. It's the Rainbow Six Siege beta, and I'm doing a giveaway for 1,000 closed beta codes. You have to have an invite to this bad boy. All you have to do is follow the Twitter below or like the Facebook or do both to get 2 entries, and I'm picking winners every day for the next 4 or 5 days. I'm giving away 1,000 of them, so you guys take advantage of that, and now, let's get into the top 10 grenades in COD history, picked by you guys. This does include lethal or tacticals, anything you can basically throw out of your hand besides C4. I decided not to let C4 be in there, even though it's probably the best air grenade ever. We decided to keep it out and keep it as real as we could. So let's jump into this. There will be honorable mentions at the end as always. Drop a like on it while you're watching, and away we go. At number 10, from the Revenger 567. The classic concussion, the first grenade you unlock, and it can be useful to stop enemies pushing you. Now, I'm going universal here. I know some Call of Duties have a better concussion than others, but we're just saying the concussion in general. You can basically knock a guy back. You can disorient the guy, run in, clear out a room, whatever you want to do. Lots of people, this is still one of their go-to grenades when it comes to Call of Duty, so very good pick. Coming in at number 9 from Matty Reed 1872, Willie Pete from Black Ops 1, just because of the name, hashtag Chaos Top 10. Now, it was a hell of a smoke bomb, to be honest with you guys, from Black Ops 1, but it made the list because a lot of you liked the name. And it's one of the coolest grenade names out there, Willie Pete. You can't go wrong with it. Just check it out. It looks like a Willie Pete. And it was back in the day when smoke bombs were actually smoke bombs, so definitely deserved to be on the list. Moving right along to number 8 from Hazard Warfare on Twitter. He says the Maltese cocktail, burn baby burn. He's specifically talking about the one from World at War. And although this thing wasn't like quick release, it wasn't, hey, grab it and then prime it and throw it or however you wanted to do it, it was badass. This thing was gnarly. Once you lit it up, lit the towel at the end of the bottle and threw it, this thing absolutely exploded in flames and engulfed anybody that was around it. So to me, this is one of my favorite ones. Coming in at number 7 from Kitty Cat Games, the Nova Gas, not only did it have the radius of a baby giant's toe, it was like you were high and underwater. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. Talking about the Nova 6 gas from Black Ops, best tweet so far today, the radius of a baby giant's toe. Basically, the green fog was huge. It was everywhere. And if you got caught up in this, you were disoriented. Like you said, you were high and underwater. You couldn't really move around much. This stuff was pretty potent if you got in it. And I remember dying from it numerous times, thinking that I could make it out of it. It was like a Guardian wrapped up in a grenade, in a way. That's the best way I can describe it. So very, very good pick. Coming in at number 6 from Jay Ardnett, the decoy grenade from Black Ops 1, no doubt. Very tactical. Haven't seen anything like it since. I agree. Bring the decoy grenade back in Black Ops 3, please. This thing, to this day, still gets me from time to time when I'm playing Black Ops. You're just like, whoa, what's going on? There's a gunfight over there. And even though I know in the back of my mind it was a decoy grenade, it's popping up on the mini HUD. Just good stuff. The decoy grenade was a very tactical grenade. It was the essence of tactical when it came to Black Ops with tactical equipment. So very, very good pick. I'm glad that one made it on there. Coming in at number 5 from X-Plan BX702, the N74 from World at War. It was an anti-tank grenade that destroyed everything. You can just look at this grenade and see how gnarly this thing is. This thing was, like he said, it destroyed everything. It was a nuke in your hand. Everything at World at War, explosive-wise, was a nuke in your hand. So this is no different, this thing. It's an anti-tank grenade. You know it's going to be devastating. Coming in at number 4 from I Love My Duo Dis or something, hashtag Chaos Top 10. Got to say the reliable flashbang. It was so annoying if you didn't have TAC masks. People still use this to the day. It's the sister grenade to the concussion. You usually pick flashbang or concussion. Do you want to disorient them or do you want to blind them? It's up to you guys, whichever way you want to go. But a lot of people pick the flashbang, so I had to put that bad boy on there. Coming in at number 3 from Festive Ash 797, has to be the EMP grenade. That thing was great for taking out campers in Black Ops 2. I totally agree. This thing was almost overpowered in a sense, and a ton of you thought this was one of the best ones, so we had to move it up the list. Coming in at number 2 from Biak Frost Diaz. You can't go wrong with the classic frag grenade. Cook it or bank it off walls, it was always reliable. This could have been number one, it was close. But the frag grenade all the way from Con 1 to Advanced Warfare, well, Advanced Warfare had a wrist launcher, but the frag grenade, especially COD 4's frag grenade. If you saw the proximity indicator, you were already dead. It was that strong. Have to give love to the frag. But at number one, so many people picked this on Twitter. The good old Simtex. Nothing better than getting a random stick across the map from L Instinct IF. And he's right. If you stuck it to them, they were not going to escape. They were going to die. Stick it to their legs. Stick it to their face. Didn't matter. If it stuck, it was game over. And so many people picked it. So the Simtex is your number one in COD history. A couple honorable mentions for you guys. There's my taco. Sensor grenades from Black Ops 2. Throw it around a corner, you can see the enemies. Basically a little VSAT in the ball of a grenade. Very, very cool. Also from R.A. Sean X. The 9-Bang from COD Ghost. Bang, bang, bang. Just unique. Wasn't really practical, but it was really cool when it went off if you charged it all the way up. Chain the Man says the Stalin grenades from World at War was just a nuke in your armory. Once again, we've already established that anything from World at War was a nuke in your hand or armory. And last but not least, I had to throw this in there. Pawn Walker, the monkey bomb from Zombies is the sickest grenade, literally the bomb. This thing, you had to give it an honorable mention at least. Hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know if we got it right or wrong. Be sure to take advantage of that 1,000 beta code giveaway for Rainbow Six Siege. And I'll see you guys later.